I'm Prashanth Vallabhajosyula, cardiothoracic surgeon in the Department of Surgery at the University of Pennsylvania Perelman School of Medicine. In addition to a clinical practice, I also conduct benchside research in transplant immunology. We're excited to share our recent work, Understanding Transplant Tissue-Specific Exosome Profiling from Peripheral Blood as a Novel Biomarker Platform in Transplantation Diagnostics. In the field of transplantation, there is still a critical need for development of non-invasive markers so that we can follow our transplant patients without doing routine biopsies in them. As an example, the patient has to come to a major institution like ours and get a biopsy. It's incredibly expensive. It can cause damage to the heart itself. Lastly, the problem with biopsies is we're doing them empirically. We have no way to titrate or monitor. We do them routinely because we don't know what's going on. So any kind of a platform that's non-invasive, where you can just get a blood sample, for example, has a huge impact on patients' quality of life. My laboratory has explored the concept of exosomes. These are small particles or nanovesicles which are released by many tissue types into our bloodstream and other bodily fluids, such as urine. What we found is that the transplant organ also releases these exosomes into the blood of the patient. In addition, the exciting thing about exosomes is that their profiles change based on the stress or injury caused to the organ. For example, in transplantation, rejection of the transplant organ can change the exosomes that they release into the bloodstream. We investigated this novel concept in the setting of animal models of islet cell transplantation and then translated these findings to the clinical setting of human allogeneic islet transplantation and human kidney transplantation. In this model, diabetic nude mice are given a critical mass of human islets to correct the hyperglycemic state. The animals are followed out over long-term follow-up to ensure that they maintain normal glycemia, and then the plasma from these animals was collected at different time points to confirm and validate first that donor islet-specific exosomes could be detected in the recipient mouse plasma. Our findings showed that throughout the follow-up, at all time points, up to 150 days post-transplantation, donor human islet-specific exosomes could be detected in the recipient plasma. In addition to confirmation that the donor-specific islet exosomes could be detected in the recipient plasma at all time points, we also validated that rejection of these islets leads to a dramatic and significant decrease in the transplant islet-specific exosome signal in the recipient plasma. This was in stark contrast to total plasma exosome profiling, which was not altered with the onset of rejection. Given these findings that immunologic rejection leads to a direct drop in the transplant islet-specific exosome signal, we then asked the question, is transplant tissue exosome platform more accurate and time-sensitive than current clinical standards for monitoring rejection in islet transplant patients, which are fasting blood glucose and glucose tolerance tests? Our studies using the animal model showed that transplant islet exosomes predicted early acute rejection more accurately and in a more time-sensitive manner than current standards such as fasting glucose and glucose tolerance tests. In fact, transplant islet exosome profiles significantly decreased even before histological findings of islet injury and early T-cell infiltration. Given validation of the biomarker potential of this platform in this animal model, we next asked the question, if transplant tissue exosome profiles herald early acute rejection, then what are the T-cells doing? Can we track their exosome profiles as well in the plasma? And if so, do they increase during the acute rejection process? To study this, we profiled T-cell exosome in the recipient plasma during the rejection process using anti-CD3 specific antibodies. Our studies utilizing the xenogeneic animal islet transplant model showed that transplant tissue-specific exosomes can be purified from recipient plasma using anti-donor major histocompatibility specific antibodies. In addition, in this model, transplant islet exosomes carried proteins and mRNAs specific to the cellular constituents of the islets, that is the beta cell component represented by insulin expression, glucagon expression represented by alpha cells, and somatostatin expression represented by delta cells. When we induced rejection in this model, we noted that immunologic rejection leads to a decrease in the endocrine hormone signatures in the transplant islet exosomes in the recipient plasma. Our studies using this model showed that transplant islet exosomes can be reliably quantified over long-term follow-up in patients, and that changes in the donor exosome signal may reflect early injury or loss of transplanted islets. Furthermore, transplant islet exosomes can be purified and characterized noninvasively from recipient plasma. Similar to the findings in the animal model, in the clinical setting as well, transplant islet exosomes co-express islet surface markers, and their cargos are specific to the cellular constituents of the transplanted islets. Next, we tested if our proposed concept can be utilized to study other transplant tissue types and if transplant exosomes can be profiled from other bodily fluids. We studied plasma and urine samples from patients with renal failure undergoing kidney transplantation. Our studies utilizing this model showed that donor kidney-specific exosomes can be quantified, purified, and characterized from recipient plasma and urine. Similar to the islet transplantation setting, in kidney transplantation, donor kidney exosomes expressed proteins specific to the renal tissues. Our study demonstrates that transplant tissue-specific exosome platform can be characterized from recipient plasma and other bodily fluids. Transplant tissue exosome quantitative profiles and their interexosomal cargos reflect immune condition-specific changes imposed upon the transplant tissue. We have demonstrated the clinical translational potential of this concept in the setting of human allogeneic islet transplantation and human kidney transplantation. Our findings warrant further detailed investigations into the non-invasive diagnostic potential of tissue-specific exosome platform. The ability to monitor these patients with just a blood sample would have significant impact on their quality of life and potentially on their survival.